Welcome back to English class. So today we will continue with dictionary part 2. And make sure, children, that you are going to sit with a book, a pen and a grammar textbook. The reason is we are going to do a lot of activity based on dictionary today. So without wasting much time, children, we will start with the activities. So yes, children, now we will start with the activities. Those who have their grammar textbook along with them, make sure that you go on page number 82 and we will start with exercise H. That's a section H. Now, the question is, tick the best answer to each question. Now, your first sentence is, if you want to know how to say a word, look at the dash. Is it a guide word or the correct answer is pronunciation? Children, you can write the answer in your notebook and let us check later what is the correct answer. Now, the next sentence, the word you are looking for is called the dash. Is it a guide word or entry word? Next, you wonder if the word you are looking for a noun or a verb. To find out, you would look up for dash. Is it a part of speech or a pronunciation? Alright, now let us check what is the answer. Yes, the correct answer is the first one. If you want to know how to say a word, look at the dash. So the answer is look at the pronunciation. Next one. The word you are looking for is called the dash. That's the guide word or the entry word? Yes, the answer is entry word. Next one. You wonder if the word you are looking for up is a noun or a verb. To find out, you would look up for dash. That's a part of speech, children. So now, children, let us quickly go ahead and check with this example. We have done a lot of examples, children. But now, to check whether we are on the correct answer, let us quickly go through this particular example. Now, what is this mountain word, children? Yes, this mountain word is your entry word, right? And what is this noun? This noun is your part of speech. Now, whenever we want to know the pronunciation of a word, besides the entry word, we will come across one bracket. And inside the bracket, they will explain us how to pronounce the word, right? So this is your pronunciation. And then, as we know further, they give us the first meaning and the second meaning along with some sample sentences, right? I hope now you are clear with what is an entry word, the part of speech, as well as the pronunciation, right? Now, let us go to the next activity. Now, children, we have more few sentences. The next one is, the word at the top of the dictionary page that helps you to find out the word you are looking for is called dash. I repeat, children, the word at the top of the dictionary. Okay, now what is the correct answer? Is it a guide word or entry word? Alright, you can write the answer in your notebook. We will check what is the correct answer later. Next one. You want to know the meaning of a word. To find the meaning, you would look at the dash. Is it a part of speech or definition? Right. Next one. You want to know how to make a word mean, that is more than one. To find out, you will look for words, singular spelling or plural spelling. So now they are asking us about more than one word, right? Now let us check what is the correct answer. Now, the word at the top of the dictionary page that helps you to find out the word you are looking for is called the guide word, children. Yes. See, you can look at this image. As we know, children, the top of the page of dictionary tells us about the guide word, right? So the correct answer is guide word. We can go ahead and check with one more example, children. See, over here it shows clearly guide words are found at the top of each page. They tell you the first and the last word that is found on that particular page. Now, if you check this particular page, the first word on this particular page is waiting game, and the last word is walk. Yes, children, so these are your guide words, right? Now, let us go to the next slide. Now, the next sentence. You want to know the meaning of a word? To find the meaning, you would look at the dash. Of course, children, the correct answer is we will look out for the definition. Next one. You want to know how to make a word mean, means it is more than one. To find out, you will look for words. Is it a singular spelling or a plural? Of course, children, it is more than one, then it is going to be a plural spelling, right? Now, don't worry, children, I'm going to give you an example over here with an image, okay? Now, this is a dictionary image. Let us check, this particular word is horse, right? Now, it is also going to give us the part of speech and which says it's noun. And along with that, it is also going to give us a plural form of horse, and the plural form is horses, right? Okay, so this is how, children, each word in the dictionary is going to, you know, show you the part of speech, the plural form, and various other forms as well, along with the definition and the sample sentences, right? Now, I hope you are very much clear. Now, let us go to the next activity. Now, children, let us go to page number 83. And we will do the exercise J. Alright? Now, use your dictionary to answer the following questions. Look up the word that is in bold. Okay. Now, over here, they have given few words which are in bold. So, we have to go to the dictionary and we have to check what is the correct meaning. Now, what we will do is, if you have a dictionary right now, you can take the dictionary for the reference, or else I have also given you a few images over here. We will check with the image as well. Now, children, the first one is the meaning of mouse pad in computer science is dash. I repeat, the meaning of mouse pad in a computer science is dash. Next, the plural of mouse is dash. Next, the abbreviation of MPH is dash. Now, let us check what is the correct answer. Alright, the meaning of mouse pad in computer science is a flat pad that provides a surface on which to use a mouse. Right? Now, your correct answer is the option B. Right? The option B is a flat pad that provides a surface on which to use a mouse. Now, the next one, children. What is the plural of mouse? Is dash. So, now, if we check our dictionary, they have given us the plural of mouse over here is mice. Yes, children, you can look over here. Yes. So, this is how your dictionary can give you the plural form as well, right? Now, the next one. The abbreviation for MPH is dash. Now, if you check your dictionary, children, you will definitely get the abbreviation, which is miles per hour. Okay, you can check over here. MPH, the abbreviation is miles per hour. All right? Now, the next sentence, the plural of potato is dash. POW stands for dash. The plural of motor is dash. The plural of lens is dash. And the plural of index is dash. Now, let us check the correct answer, children. If you have your dictionary, you can go and check with your dictionaries as well. Now, the plural form of potato is potatoes. Okay? Now, POW stands for prisoner of war. I repeat, POW stands for prisoner of war. Next, the plural of moto is motos. Next, plural of lens is lenses. The plural of index is indexes. All right, these are your correct answer. Now let us quickly check the image of dictionary. So yes children, I have given you a few images from the dictionary as an example. All right, let us check with POW. Now as we know, POW, the abbreviation is prisoner of war. Okay, next one, plural of moto is motos, right? MOTTOES. Next one, plural of potato is potatoes. It's given again here in the dictionary. You can check out your dictionary, children. Next one is index. Index, over here it's indexes. Alright, that's the plural form of index. So now children, this is how your dictionary will give you the detailed information about abbreviation as well as the plural form of any particular word. Now children, let us go to page number 83 and we will just do the exercise K. The question is, choose the definition that best fits the bold term as used in each sentence. Now, the first one is, her voice was so obscure that I couldn't decide what she was saying. What could be the correct answer, children? Is it to reduce, dark, indistinctly heard, or humble? Don't worry children, we will check what is the correct answer. Next one, I had to fast for 24 hours before my physical examination. Okay, what is the correct answer? Is it move quickly, firmly fixed, to not eat food, lasting or permanent? If you know the answer children, you can write the answers in your notebook and we will cross verify it later. Next, he had a fat lip after falling down the stairs. What could be the correct answer? Is it fertile, very little enhanced, obese or puffed up? Next one, the baby duck is covered with dune from a higher to a lower place. Or what could be the options, like learned to known perfectly, towards to or on the ground floor or bottom, fine soft fluffy feathers. Next, I really feel for you. What could be the answer, children? Is it overall impression or effect? To perceive through that sense of touch? To examine by touching or to have compassion? Alright, now it's time to go ahead and check what is the correct answer. Alright, your first sentence. Her voice was so obscure that I couldn't decide what she was saying. Well, the definition is indistinctly heard. Okay, second one, I had to fast for 24 hours before my physical examination to not eat food. Fasting means not eating food. Next one, he had a fat lip after falling down the stairs. Okay, the correct answer is puffed up. Next one, the baby duck is covered with dune. Answer is fine soft fluffy feathers. Next, I really feel for you. The correct answer is to have compassion. Alright children, now let us quickly check the dictionary images. Alright children, now the first one, the dictionary image of fast over here is given and there are, you know, many definitions and sample sentences are given in your dictionary. You can make sure that you will definitely go through the dictionary image and check what is the answer again. Next one children, it's obscure. Again over here you can check. They have given almost three meanings or three definitions. Alright. Next one, feel. This is how the word feel looks in your dictionary children. And you can check out how many definitions they have given for feel as well. Alright, I'm very sure now you know how to check the dictionary. Okay, so without fail, make sure that you are definitely going to do this exercise and on daily basis check at least 5 to 6 words in your dictionary, and you will definitely be, you know, very you can say expert in understanding how to go ahead and check the words, entry words, then your guide words, your definitions and sample sentences as well. Now let us go to the next activity, children. Now let us go to page number 84 and do the exercise L. It says tricky plurals. Look into the dictionary and fill in the blanks. Alright, so make sure that you are going to sit with the dictionary and we will do this exercise as well. The first one is a species of fungus, some poisonous dash. Okay, we will check out what is the correct answer, children. If you know the answer, you can write down in your notebook. Next, on the bottom shelf, dash, a long line of dash. On the bottom shelf, a long line of dash. Next, a sore tooth, a set of false dash. Next, a young female deer, a herd of wild dash. A sharp knife, a set of kitchen dash. Now let us check the correct answer, children. A species of fungus, some poisonous dash. So what is the plural form of fungus, children? Yes, it's none other than fungi. Next one, on the bottom shelf, a long line of dash. So what is the plural form of shelf, children? It's shelves, right? Okay, next, a sore tooth. Okay, now what's the correct answer? Yes, it's teeth, right? Next, a young female deer, a herd of wild deer, that's right. Next one, a sharp knife, a set of kitchen knives, right? That's the correct answer, children. Now let us check the next one. So yes, children, this is how the image comes in your dictionary. This is how it looks in your dictionary, children. This is the word knife. If you check, they have given the plural form of knife as well. Octopus, then shelves, tooth, right? Now we will check what are the further new words we can go ahead and do for the plural form. A holy leaf, a pile of fallen dash. In the first half, both dash at the game. The feather of a goose, some flying dash. A potted cactus, a row of flowering dash. A giant octopus, a sea full of dash. Now let us check the correct answer, children. Holy leaf, a pile of fallen leaves. That's right. Next, in the first half, both halves. Next, the feather of a goose, some flying geese. Right. Next, a potted cactus, a row of flowering cacti. Right. Next, a giant octopus, a sea full of octopuses, right? So these are the plural form of all the given words. Okay, now we will check with the next activity. Again on page number 84, there is one exercise, M. Fill in the blank spaces with either a letter F or the letter PH to make a word. Alright, it's very simple. Let us check how many of you are able to do it. Dash, R-A-S-E. Okay, let us see what word we can actually form. Next one is dash, R-A-M-E. Okay, next, dash, O-R-M-A-T. Next, O-B-I-A. Next, O-R-T-N-I-G-H-T. Okay, now let us see how many of you are able to do these or form these words correctly. Yes, children, the first word is phrase. Okay, it's P-H-R-A-S-E, that's phrase. Second, it's that's frame. Okay, F-R-A-M-E. Next, format. Okay, F-O-R-M-A-T, format. Next, it's phobia, P-H-O-B-I-A. And the next one is fortnight, F-O-R-T-N-I-G-H-T. Alright, so I'm very sure that you are clear with all these simple words. So yes, children, I'm very sure now you're clear with dictionary activities and also how to find the entry word, the guide words, and what are the definitions and how to find the plural form and the abbreviation form of the words as well. And yes, children, make sure that you are going to practice 5 to 7 words daily from the dictionary, and you are actually going to frame the sentences as well from these words. Okay, so till we meet for the next session, children, take care. Bye bye.